this next hunt we're about to do, we were at the end of the rut, and we had a situation where we had the deer come in to the doe estrus year, and he started eating a bunch of acorns and stuff. And it was a very tense situation, and Dad will talk to you in a few minutes about what happened. But we were in the buck was basically where that Reinhardt buck is right now. And he was munching on some acorns, and it was a morning hunt, so as light was coming up, you know, the deer fed in the dark, and then he was done eating. That's how it happens. He was done eating by the time good camera light happened. So we were like, oh my word, it's do or die, we got to get this done. So the deer was kind of facing me, and then when I drew my bow, he looked up at me, and it was a very tense situation because I had to hold it full draw for a few seconds, as you'll see, because we were over the shoulder in this hunt. But what happened was, Dad has pounded it into me since I was a kid to be prepared to shoot a walking deer if you have to. So a good way to get your, I know you're probably thinking right now, oh my goodness, a walking deer, that's crazy. I've never even shot at anything walking. That sounds unattainable. But we can tell you that we've got a thing here. We got a Reinhardt target on a homemade dolly, and we've got somebody standing at a safe distance with a rope. And we practice real hunting situations. It's what we talk about all the time in our seminars, is make your practice situation as realistic as possible. So if we anticipate that we're going to shoot a walking deer, well, guess what? We're going to practice shooting at a walking deer. So we got the Reinhardt target on a rope, and we're going to have somebody pull it. And what happened was, the deer looked at me, and then he started to get nervous because this is a high-pressure deer in Michigan. And he was leaving. I could tell by his body language that he was leaving. And as he turned to leave, I released. As soon as I knew that I was gonna make a nice kill zone shot, I released, because I'd been practiced up, and this came first nature to me. It's instinctive to me to shoot a deer at the first opportunity, whether that deer's moving or not. And I urge you guys to practice this. Don't ever try to shoot a moving animal unless you know beyond the shadow of a doubt that you can make the shot happen. And the only way that that's gonna happen is practicing in the off season for a possible situation during season. So here goes. We're going to take a shot at this and see what happens, and then we're going to go into this hunt and show you how it really happened in real time with a real hoss buck in real high pressure situation. And it was amazing. You guys are going to love it. So let's check this out. And that's exactly what I did in this hunt. So that's cool, man. It gets me fired up to go bow hunting.